The Galaxy S4 name is not the only thing which the Galaxy S4 Mini is borrowing from its bigger brother. So today, we're going to compare the Samsung Android flagship with the Samsung Android Mini flagship. I'm Anton, this is Pocket Now, and you're watching Samsung Galaxy S4 Mini versus Samsung Galaxy S4. Let's go check it out. There's so much more to the Samsung Galaxy S4 than what we'll show you in this comparison video. For an in-depth look at all the aspects of the Samsung flagship, make sure to check out our full text and video reviews. While you're at it, follow us on social media so you never miss a beat. We are past the point of complaining about the same materials and fairly similar Galaxy S3 and Note 2-like design. We're accepting the Galaxy S4 as it is, one of the best Android phones on the market at the moment. And while we're at it, we need to mention that this Galaxy S4 right here is the GTI 9500, the Exynos 5 version with a octa-core, which is really a dual quad-core processor. The Galaxy S4 Mini is the mini Android flagship from Samsung. It's a huge leap forward in every aspect from its predecessor, the Galaxy S3 Mini, and it tries to offer a premium-like experience for those who either find the Galaxy S4, its bigger brother, too expensive or too big. In this comparison, we'll take a look at hardware, software and user experience, as well as the camera. Love it or hate it, we'll have to put up with hyperglaze polycarbonate and the good old, and by now, overused design some more. According to rumors, Samsung might be switching materials soon and, on the same note, we're crossing our fingers for a new design. Initially, we were quite sad that we didn't get the darker flavor of the Galaxy S4 Mini, but as we come to think of it, it's better this way, because we can show you just how well the white version conceals fingerprints, or how badly the black mist attracts and displays them. There's a huge difference nonetheless. There's nothing really interesting to note on the materials and design end. These two phones are identical except for the measurements. And while we talk about size, the Galaxy S4 Mini is indeed a mini phone compared to today's 5 inches and above. But at 4.3 inches, it could have been, and not so long ago, considered a large phone. By today's Android standards and recent trends, it is a mini alright, but itself has a larger screen than Apple's iPhone 5 for instance, while maintaining about the same physical dimensions. Button placement is the same on both devices, and so is the camera, speaker, and the majority of ports. This is, indeed, a true Galaxy S4 miniature. However, when we talk specs, the Galaxy S4 simply destroys the S4 Mini on paper. That's not to say that the S4 Mini is a slow phone, not at all. More on that in our full upcoming review. We have either a quad-core Snapdragon 600 at 1.9 GHz, an octa-core Exynos 5 processor at 1.6 and 1.2 GHz for the dual quad-core construction, or, more recently, a Snapdragon 800 processor on the LTE Advanced version powering the GS4. The Galaxy S4 Mini is more modest with its dual-core 1.7 GHz CPU. 2 GB of RAM versus 1.5 GB of RAM on this S4 Mini, 16, 32 and 64 GB storage versus 8 GB of storage on the S4 Mini, both of course expandable via microSD, and 13 megapixels on the GS4 versus 8 megapixels on the miniature sibling. A 5-inch Full HD Super AMOLED screen takes up the front of the GS4, and its smaller relative packs a quite modest 4.3-inch Super AMOLED screen with QHD resolution, which is 540x960. The rest of the usual suspects are present on both phones, including the IR Blaster and NFC. What we really wish was there on the GS4 Mini, and it's there alright on the GS4, is the LED notification. Samsung could have, should have, equipped the Galaxy S4 Mini with a notification light. We would have loved that. Android 4.2.2 is powering both of these phones, and Samsung's own TouchWiz user interface brings the company's signature to the user experience. While the Galaxy S4 is packed with features, some of them you'll probably never even use, the S4 Mini is missing AirView as well as Air Gesture. The LED indicator option is also missing from the settings, as it is of course missing from the phone itself. The rest is just about the same, offering a surprisingly fluid user experience on the S4 Mini. And, since the notification light is missing from the Mini, all the extra sensors that are employed by S-Health on the GS4 are missing too, but we don't really feel the need for them. There are also some slight tweaks to accommodate the smaller form factor, like the 4-row keyboard on the Mini versus the 5-row input on the GS4, but there's no deal breaker here. Comparing performance between two phones that are this far apart in specs on paper might seem odd, but we're happy to see this little fella right here keeping up. It doesn't lag at all when compared side by side with its bigger brother on steroids. hard as we tried, we didn't manage to see a real difference in performance between these two phones when doing day-to-day tasks like launching applications and even browsing the web. We expect this, of course, from the Galaxy S4, but it comes as a pleasant surprise from the S4 Mini. Of course, we have a lot to thank to Andre Jellybean for this. Drama, animated photo, and eraser camera shooting modes are not present on the S4 Mini, but a certain continuous shoot mode has been added, something which the S4 achieves easily via burst mode. Video stabilization is also missing from the S4 Mini, but aside from these, the camera interface and the entire picture snapping experience is the same. Samsung even bundled the photo editing application for easily fixing or applying filters to your stills. We're talking 13 megapixels versus 8 megapixels here, but the GS4 Mini doesn't disappoint. Surely it sometimes delivers somewhat lower quality images, but the colors as well as the exposure seem to be spot on. The Galaxy S4 Mini puts up a decent fight in this category too, and the sample images can surely tell you more. At the end of the day, there's a difference of about $250 between these two phones, if we're talking unlocked, SIM and carrier free. Of course, we want to thank our friends over at clove.co.uk for supplying us with this Galaxy S4 Mini review unit. If you prefer a smaller screen, you'll love the Galaxy S4 Mini. Don't be fooled by the lower specs. Surely we would have loved to see a 720p display and of course that LED notification, but if you can live with that or without those, it is an exceptional Android device. Of course, our conclusion on the S4 Mini will arrive soon with the occasion of our full review, so stay tuned for that. That's gonna wrap up our comparison between the Samsung Galaxy S4 Mini and the Samsung Galaxy S4. I've been Anton Dinod, you can follow me on Facebook as well as on Twitter, and if you've liked this video, please give us a thumbs up. Thank you very much for watching. Till next time.